Good morning, students all. Welcome back once again. Last class we finished atoms up to problem number 7 in the NEET corner. Today we will finish, in this session we will finish that remaining questions. So see, page atoms, chapter name is atoms. Up to question number 7 is completed. From the 8th question we will continue the class. So question number 8, page number 361. Okay, see the question, what they are asking. The wavelength of the first line of Lyman series for hydrogen atom is equal to the second line of Balmer series for a hydrogen atom like iron. The atomic number of the hydrogen like iron is what? So 1 by lambda is equal to z square into r by 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square formula. Okay, for a hydrogen atom what will happen? Lyman series they mentioned. Lyman series, wavelength of the first line of Lyman series. So 1 by lambda L is equal to 1 square into R. This will be 1 by 1 square minus 1 by 2 square. So here 1 by lambda L is equal to R into 1 minus 1 by 4. This value will be 3 by 4. Next. Next what they mentioned is second line of Balmer series for the hydrogen like atom. Okay. Then 1 by lambda b is equal to z square into r, and that value 1 by 4, 1 by 2 square, this is minus second line means 1 by 4 square. So 1 by lambda b is equal to z square r into, so if we calculate this value, so 1 by 4 minus 1 by 16, so 12 divided by 4 into 16. 4 3s will cancel. Let it be equation 2. You divide 1 by 2. What they gave, these two are equal, they mentioned. These two are equal. Therefore, 3r by 4 is equal to z square r into 3 by 16. 3r, 3r will cancel. So z square r is equal to, z r will also cancel, z square is equal to 4, z is equal to 2. So 8th question, it will be first option. Okay, next, see the 9th question. What they are asking, out of the following, which one is not a possible energy for a hydrogen atom, possible energy for a photon to be emitted by hydrogen atom according to Bohr's atomic model? Okay, if you observe the spectral lines of hydrogen series, this will be minus 13.6 electron volt. Here 13.6 by 4, so this value will be how much? Minus 3.4 electron volt. 13.6 by 9 this is, because the energy will be in the nth orbit, minus 13.6 by n square. So according to that, this energy will be equal to minus 1.51 electron volt. Here if you substitute n is equal to 4, 13.6 by 16, that value 0.85. And if you observe this energy level, minus 0.5 electron volt. Okay, so they gave four options. First one will be 1.9 electron volt. Second one will be 11.1 electron volt. Third one will be 13.6 electron volt. And fourth one will be 0.65 electron volt. Okay, so you observe the difference between this, difference between these two. If you calculate, this will be 0.65 electron volt. If electron jumps from here to here, it will emit a photon of energy 0.65 electron volt, which is not possible. We have to calculate. If the electron jumps from here, then it will emit 13.6 electron volt. So this energy will be possible, this energy will be possible. And if you observe the difference between these two, so this value will be 1.9 electron volt. So from here to here it jumps, it will emit photon of energy 1.9. So these three are possible. This is not possible. If you take the difference between these two, then that will be 12.1 electron volt. This is not 11.1 electron volt, which is not possible. Means second option will be the answer for this. So ninth question, second option. Next, see the 10th question. What they are asking, electron in hydrogen atom first jumps from third excited state to second excited state, and then second excited state to first excited state. Third excited state means n is equal to 4, n is equal to 3, let it be n is equal to 2. What happened? Electron jumps from third excited state to second excited state. Here to here it jumped. It emit energy of wavelength lambda 1. And second excited state to first excited state means n is equal to 2. Here it emit energy of wavelength lambda 2. Lambda 1, lambda 2 relation is what? So 1 by lambda, here in which atom this is? Hydrogen. So 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. 1 by lambda 1 is equal to R into 1 by 9 minus 1 by 16. Here this will be 3 N1, N2 will be 4. So how much it will be? 7R divided by 9 into 16, this will be 144. So lambda 1 is equal to 144 by 7R. Next, in second case, 1 by lambda 2 is equal to R into 1 by 4 minus 1 by 9, this value 5R by 36. So lambda 2 is equal to 36 by 5R. You divide this to lambda 1 by lambda 2, 144 by 7R into 5R by 36. So RR will cancel, 36 four times will cancel, this will be 20 by 7. So lambda 1 by lambda 2 is equal to 20 by 7. 10th question, it will be 4th option. Okay, note it down. Next, see the 11th one. What they are asking, an electron of a stationary hydrogen atom passes from the fifth energy level to the ground level. The velocity of the atom acquired as a result of photon emission is. So 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. From fifth energy level, electron jumps to first energy level, ground level. Then how much velocity of the photon will be, how much they are asking. So find the wavelength. 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 by 1 minus 1 by 5 whole square. So this value 24R by 25. We got 1 by lambda. We know P is equal to from P is equal to H by lambda. So here H, 1 by lambda plus 24R by 25. 1 by lambda plus, we can write 24R by 25. Then P is equal to MV 24HR by 25. From that, V value will be 24HR by 25M. So 11th question, it will be first option. Okay, next, see the next question, 12th. What they are asking, the transition from the state N is equal to 3 to N is equal to 1 in a hydrogen-like atom results in ultraviolet radiation. Infrared radiation will obtained from the transition from 2 to 1, 3 to 2, 4 to 2, 4 to 3 means it will be 4 to 3. Initially in the synopsis we discussed, check that 12th question will be 4th option. Next, see the 13th, what they are asking. Ratio of longest wavelengths corresponding to Lyman and Balmer series in a hydrogen spectrum will be. Okay. Then here Lyman and Balmer, if you consider in Lyman, thirteen, 1 by lambda L is equal to R into 1 by 1 square minus 1 by 2 square. So this value 3 R by 4. From this lambda L is equal to 4 by 3 R. Let it be 1. Next, Balmer, they asked in Balmer, one by lambda B is equal to 1 by 2 square minus 1 by 3 square. So this value we will get it as 5 R by 36. From this lambda B is equal to 36 by 5 R. Then lambda L by lambda B, how much they are asking? This value 13th, lambda will write here, lambda L by lambda B, 4 by 3 R into 5 R by 36. 4 9s will cancel. So this value 5 by 27. Okay. 13th, it will be second option. Okay. Next, 14th, you see. What they are asking. Hydrogen atom in the ground state is excited by a monochromatic radiation of wavelength 975 angstrom unit. Number of spectral lines in the resulting spectrum would be, emitted will be. So, E is equal to 12,400 by lambda, 12,400 by, they gave this value as 975 angstrom unit. If you calculate this value, we will get this value as 12.75 electron volt. Okay, if you write the energy levels here, minus 13.6 electron volt by 4 means minus 3.4 electron volt, minus 1.151 electron volt, minus 0.85 electron volt. And this value, next one will be minus 5.58 electron volt. So this energy is there, means it is jumped from here to here. Is it clear? So here to here it jumped, it will release this energy. So it is jumping from the fourth orbit. So electron is jumping from fourth orbit. Okay, you observe the difference of these two energy levels, minus 0.85, -13.6. So 13.6 -0.85. So if you calculate, we will get this value, or 12.75. So it is jumping from the fourth orbit. Therefore, number of spectral lines capital N is equal to N into N minus 1 by 2, 4 into 4 minus 1 by 2. So this value will be 6. So how many spectral lines will be there means 6. Okay. So here 14th question, it will be third option. Clear? Next. See the 15th. What they are asking, see. Consider third orbit of helium atom using non-relativistic approach. The speed of the electron in the orbit is z is equal to 2, k value is given. For this one, shortcut is there. Velocity of the electron in any orbit, v is equal to 2.19 into 10 power 6 into z by n. This is the formula. Here 2.1 into 10 power 6 helium, z value 2, n value they gave third orbit. Okay, if we calculate this one, finally this value 1.46 into 10 power 6 meter per second. So 15th question, it will be first option. Okay, next, see the 16th question. What they are asking. In the spectrum of hydrogen, the ratio of longest wavelength in the Lyman series to the longest wavelength in the Balmer series is. So same 13th question, longest wavelength in the Lyman series and longest wavelength in the Balmer series. Answer will be 5/27. Same question number 13 in NEET, just in this class only we discussed. So answer will be λ1/λ2. That ratio will be equal to 5/27. Okay, next 17. So 16th question, what is the option here? First option. Next, see the 17th question. What they are asking. Given the values of Rydberg constant is 10 power 7 meter inverse, the wave number of the last line of the Balmer series in hydrogen spectrum will be. So wave number nu bar is equal to r into 1/(n1)² - 1/(n2)². So this is r into Balmer na 2² - infinity. This value will be r/4. They gave r value as 10 power 7. 10 power 7 by 4. I am writing it as 10 by 4 into 10 power 6. So this value 2.5 into 10 power 6 meter per second. No, they gave directly like this. here only they gave 1 by 4 means 0.25 into 10 power 7 meter per second. Okay, so 17th, it will be third option. Next, 18. What they are asking, see, in an electron in a hydrogen atom jumps from third orbit to second orbit, it emits a photon of wavelength lambda. When it jumps from fourth orbit to third orbit, the corresponding wavelength of the photon will be, in this class only we did the same model. Question number 10, you see, that and this are both are same only. So, same question. Number 10 in NEET. Just now we did that one. So answer that will be 20 by 7 lambda. So 18th question, it will be third option. Okay. Next, see the 19. What they are asking, see, the ratio of wavelength of the last line of Balmer series and last line of Lyman series is, so 1 by lambda L is equal to R into 1 by 1 square minus 1 by infinity, so lambda L is equal to R. Next, 1 by lambda b is equal to 1 r into 1 by 2 square minus 1 by infinity, so lambda b is equal to 4 by r. This ratio they are giving, what they are asking, r by 4 na, this will be 1 by r ma. Lambda b by lambda l na they are asking, lambda b by lambda l 4 by r into r by 1, this value will be 4. So 19th question, it will be second option. Next, see the 20. What they are asking, see. The ratio of kinetic energy to the total energy of an electron in an hydrogen atom. So, we know total energy is equal to minus kinetic energy. So, kinetic energy by total energy will be kinetic energy by minus ke minus 1 by 1. 1 is 2 minus 1. So, 1 is 2 minus 1. Okay. So, 20, it will be second option. Next, last question, 21. What they are asking, see. Total energy of an electron in an atom in an orbit is minus 3.4 electron volt. Its kinetic energy and potential energies are... kinetic energy is equal to minus total energy. Total energy they gave minus 3.4. So it becomes 3.4 electron volt. And potential energy is equal to 2 times of total energy, 2 into minus 3.4 minus 6.8 electron volt. So 21st, it will be third option. Okay. With this, this chapter is completed. Still two chapters are there pending. One is nuclei and another one will be semiconductor devices. In the coming classes, we will try to finish those parts also.